Okay, as you can see, let's see. I'm running the latest engine 2.0.2. And this is performing a task where I've just got through importing one of my external hard drives, Tupac collection, and I'm inserting it here in the collection, which it's analyzing all the music and stuff, and basically however I have it here, it should come out here. So whenever you connect your Prime 4 or whatever Denon, you know, hardware you're using, whenever you go to DJ and you go to the playlist collection up here, you know, on your icon, it separates all this information here with the BPMs already analyzed and, you know, the keys and all this and that. And it puts it in whatever order you're gonna want to put it. I personally choose the BPM from, you know, the slowest to the fastest. And in some cases, I mean, you can do the title. You can go A to Z or Z to A. The artist, you know. There's so many ways of doing your libraries whenever you're doing your mixing. Or you can separate everything in subcrates. I hate doing all that crap because it's just too much of a hassle. You gotta remember everything where it's at. And in this drive, I think I have maybe, I don't know, 2 terabytes worth of music. Even though this is an 8 terabyte disk external hard drive. And I'm sharing this because one of my issues that, you know, I just got through getting off the phone with them themselves was that on my other PC, which I strictly use for Serato, this one I use for virtual. And that's only because it's got a Ryzen 5. A Ryzen 5 will not activate Serato, which are Denon, you know, Prime 4. I don't know if it'll work for any other Denon product or whatever. But, you know, it took me months, a long time ago, in October of 2019, calling, you know, and talking to actual human beings at Serato and Denon. It took us at least an average of 3 months to figure out that this was the reason that it would not work. It would work on my laptop, perfect. You know, I could mix, you know, Serato, you know, just like you can do virtual on your laptop. I mean, you don't need anything. But what was the fun of that, you know? I mean, what's the use of getting such an expensive piece of hardware and not being able to utilize it? Even though I could utilize the Denon Prime 4 by itself. So one of the things that they just got through informing me, you know, Denon, was on this hard drive. I mean, yeah, my actual hard drive itself. Well, this is coming up now because, you know, it's a brand new database or whatever. But on my old computer, the database, I ended up erasing it altogether. And reason being was that database 2 folder, the way that you allocate this, you know, like for instance, you know, this is a disk drive here. And, I still have to erase it on here, I think. Well, anyways, you would end up coming up here, you know, say if you have a Windows, and you would have went here. It was here. Underneath here, I had a folder called Database 2, and I ended up erasing that. I uninstalled Engine 2.0.2 and reinstalled it, but prior to that, I allocated it and found the Engine 6.1, which, you know, I mean, I've got it up here. So, you know, y'all can, if y'all are not as tech savvy as I am, you know what the hell I'm talking about. But I reverted back to this and I loaded it up. And even with this drive that I'm just doing right now on here, it was able to load and function, you know, okay, whatever, you know. I like to keep everything fresh and updated and stuff like that. And there's always a reason behind stuff, happening or whatever. And, to get this for updating your Prime 4, for example, on this page, let me see if I can bring it up still. Well, damn. Okay, let's restore these pages. Okay, on here, this is the brand new page. ¿Qué pasó? So from here, when you log into your account, whatever, right? This is how you can tell that everything's legit, Well, I don't gotta log in. I was already logged in, whatever. But you'll come to the actual Denon folder itself. It's gonna recognize that you have a legit, deal, whatever. And you would just click on here, like it's telling you, click here, for this, because otherwise, if say for instance, like for myself, I ended up having to find the Prime 4. Let me see, where the hell is it at? There's so many things here that you utilize. It's way up here. Okay, yeah, it's way up here. All right, so you have these right here, you have these right here, and you have these. Where the hell is my damn Prime 4? Okay, here it goes. You see, on the software, you used to have to do this to update, for a different version, which is always either a little bit ahead of the versions before the actual unit itself. Like here, we still have the those drivers. I don't know if they still work or not. But you would click on here, and this is gonna lead you to this right here. Here you can tell, whatever. I mean, this is telling you about, what's up, and then it's telling you all the information about the previous and, how all of these other deals, whatever. Other bugs and stuff like that. So, one is for your desktop. You choose either Windows or Mac. And then the other one's for the operating system for the actual hardware itself. And you have to go to select your device. In my case, it would be a Prime 4. And that's how I ended up getting this right here. And then you can either do this via Wi-Fi, or you can have it connected to your PC, and you'll be able to update that ways, and everything should work fine. So again, if you are having issues, you would end up having to go into your actual programming file. You find this, the Engine Prime, and within this Engine Prime, you should have a deal where the database, would come up. It's not on this one anymore because, I was told by the technician at Denon to go ahead and erase the Denon file. And normally you would click on it, and this will come up. I don't know if it's trying to load or what the hell it's trying to do, but now that I don't need it, I'm gonna go ahead and erase it from all of my drives. And I was just going to do a follow-up on it. Come back to seeing why this whatchamacallit is not doing what it's supposed to. But that's what it was. The issue with not having to being able to update or load or anything like that was because of it. So other than that, everything is looking good. And yeah, hopefully everybody does what they need to do, and you won't have any more issues. Like I said, everything's working good now. All right, so I'll keep following up with y'all and seeing what happens afterwards. Thank you.